there's a couple of them. Oh, you remember Darlene? She married that one football player. I never went to any football games, but he was supposed to be, what was it? Halfback or something, I don't know. It's something good if you're in football. But he was one of those. I just like to look at the uniforms.
What was her last name?
Darlene Simpson?
Yeah.
Well, it's not anymore. She married him.
Yeah.
I don't even remember his name. You remember Lisa Lamport's party for New Year's Eve? I think it was our junior year or senior year.
Junior.
Yeah, and you were spending the night with me. I got so bummed.
Let's look up Bill. Wonder what he's doing now.
I think I read something in the paper about him. He was missing for like 2 or 3 days and everyone was looking for him. And then these little kids found him in a building that was under construction and he was dead.
Oh my gosh.
They found him at the bottom of an elevator shaft. Mm-hmm. And there was no elevator in it, and he just kind of walked off it or something.
Was there any alcohol in his blood?
The coroners never did really release anything as to why he was in there or why he was dead, and the police couldn't figure it out.
That's really strange. It's so hard to believe he's dead.
I know what you mean. Hang on a second.
Hello? Hello?
Probably wrong number or something.
Yeah.
Well, it's getting kind of late, and tomorrow I've got a plane that leaves at like 7:30, and I haven't finished packing, so I better get going so I can get some sleep. Next time you get back to Chicago, come see me, okay?
Oh, I will. Thanks for coming by.
Bye. I'll see you later.
Okay, call me when you get back so I know your plane leaves.
Okay, I will.
Bye-bye.
Now, ghost to ghost, there will be no guests tonight. This program is entirely caller-driven. Either I will call you because you have sent me a ghost story and your phone number, or you will call me either way. The subject is only one, and that's ghosts. Are they an important subject? Yes. Not just tonight, but 365 days a year, because question really in our life, and that is, do we have eternal souls which survive our physical death, inevitable and growing up minute by minute for all of us? Is there something that comes after this? It's the biggest question in the world, so is it an important subject? Yes. And those stories that I want from you are the very best, nothing but the best, the scariest, the most frightening. Emails and ghost stories. I've selected a few. And we will take, of course, from the phone somehow for tomorrow. What is an important question? Is there any more important question in this life than whether that's it? Whether it's the worms in and out, or whether there's actually something that comes after this? Well, the stories are going to roll tonight. If you have big orange Halloween cojones, you might want to turn the lights off and sort of provide a set setting for what's to come.
Somebody they wanted to tell that they loved before they left and didn't get a chance to. Children that are left behind that you wanted to be sure understood that you loved them, because what could be more important at that time? Really nothing. Does all this add up to life after death? I think that it does. That's why we do these programs.
Who's there? Hello?
Some spirits appear to remain here on this world. I think they can't go anywhere else.
Okay, who is this? Quit playing games!
If you're seeing a ghost or being bothered by one, we want to hear from you.
You get out of here.
Wilma. Wilma!
Do you know my name?
It's on the marriage certificate, remember?
Oh, mister, I've never seen you before in all my life.
Cameo of a man who has just lost his most valuable possession. He doesn't know about the loss yet. In fact, he doesn't even know about the possession. Because like most people, David Gurney has never really thought about the matter of his identity. But he's going to be thinking a great deal about it from now on. Because that is what he's lost. And his search for it is going to take him into the darkest corners of the world.
Thank you.
We're going to delve into a whole different world, and one that I want to warn some of you is going to frighten you. And there are people who become upset by discussions involving the paranormal and ghosts. And if you are one of those people, I urge you right now to turn your radio off. Go watch TV or something. Listen to somebody else's radio program. Because this morning we're going on...
We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording an error, please check the number or try your call again.
My uncle had died in a car accident. And I thought, oh, wow, this is pretty weird, you know?
We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service.
Things throughout my life. And, during, 1911...
We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been... If you feel you have reached this recording an error, please check the number or try your call again.